Hey everyone, and welcome to this week's video lecture, Exporting a Project. In this tutorial, I'm going to lead you through building your scene and project into a standalone EXE game, as well as packaging out some of your assets, such as prefabs, scripts, or anything else, into a package that other players can download and use in their projects, much in the same way that we imported the standard assets that come with Unity. So one of the things you might notice right off the bat is my Unity looks different. That's because I've activated a 30-day free pro license, and it's by no means necessary for the rest of these lectures or even for this course, but I wanted to show you guys how to do it in case you wanted to try out the pro version of Unity. It offers a lot more features, and it's super easy to do. So I'm going to start off with that. To activate a pro license or a trial, go up to the Help window here and go to Manage License. From here there's an option, Activate New License. So we're going to click that. Because I've already activated my pro trial, it's going to be a little different. But here you're going to want to activate a 30-day trial. Hit OK. And then you're going to enter in a Unity login if you don't have one already. It's almost instantaneous once you activate. You should see your screen change. The UI will change to this darker color, and you'll have access to all of the pro features that were currently or previously locked. In one of the later lectures, light mapping, I'll be referencing some of the Unity Pro features that you can possibly use, but for the purpose of this tutorial, we're just going to continue to work in Unity Basic stuff. We're not going to do anything that has Pro. So let's move right along. The first thing that we want to do is package out one of our prefabs that we made so a teammate could download into his project, or you could release it on the internet, or whatever you want to do with it. So to do that, we're going to take our collectible prefab, our little boxes here. And all we want to do is right-click and go to Export Package. This brings up the exporting package window. And this is a checklist of all the things that can export along with your prefab. Now down here there's an Include Dependencies checkmark, and if you uncheck that, it will only specifically export that prefab and none of the dependent scripts or items that go with it. For us, we want to include some scripts because that's what makes our prefab unique. So let's go ahead and leave these checked, but we don't want all of these. As you can see, some of these, or most of these ones here, are the standard assets. Now it won't really hurt in some cases to package these out, but we already have, we're going to assume that the person who downloads these already has the standard assets, and this will make our package smaller. So let's go ahead and uncheck these, because really the ones that we are interested in here is our prefab, the material on the cube, and the three scripts that make it run. So next let's hit the export button. We're just going to click on the desktop and call it collectible prefab. And there it is. So now we can trust that it works, or we can test it. Let's go ahead and test it. We're going to do that by creating a new project. So go to New Project. We're going to choose the character controller and the standard assets, because those are the things that are in our that we're using in our current project that are not bundled with our package. So let's go ahead and create this. Now we have a brand new project. So what we want to do is go into Assets, Import Package, Import Custom Package, and import our collectible prefab. Here's the importing window, and it tells us these are all new items for us to download. So we're going to import these. And there is our collectible box. If we click on it and go in here, we should see that the collectible object script is on it, and we have a collectible object master as well as killbox script to attach to other things. So let's go ahead and leave this project and open ours back up. So let's say we have finished our game here. This is all we want, and we just want someone to play it outside of our Unity editor. To do that, we're going to go to File, Build Settings. Now this is the build window. Now up here, you probably won't have anything in your scenes to build area. So you're going to want to hit add current, which will add whatever scene you're currently in to the build order. Now this window up here, this area, basically is going to be a list of different scenes in your game that are going to be checked or unchecked. And depending on what you have selected is what's going to be built into your final game. So if you have some scenes that are like testing scenes that you don't want to be in your finished game, you would leave them unchecked here or don't even add them to the list. But we want our only scene, the first scene, to be in there, so go ahead and add it and make sure it's checked. Next, we're going to be choosing our platform to build to, and we're going to be building to the PC, Mac, and Linux standalone. You can choose what platform you're targeting. I'm going to leave it at Windows, and I'm going to leave it at 32-bit. Now, there's one thing we want to change. Let's go into player settings here. Now, player settings can also be accessed from the project settings under Edit and Player. And these settings offer different things, mostly to deal with building. And right now, we're going to be under the settings for PC, Mac, and Linux standalone. We want to uncheck the default is full screen mode and set the resolution to whatever you'd like. The default is 1024x768, so I'm going to leave it at that. Once that's done, let's go ahead and hit build. And we're going to choose a name for it. I'm going to choose call mine Game113 example. And let's go ahead and build it. Let's minimize our Unity. And we here have on the desktop now a Game113 example.exe. This brings up a configuration. You want to check that it's windowed and that choose the resolution and the graphics quality you'd like. You can change input here if you'd like. When you're ready, hit play. This brings up the standard Unity splash screen, and here's our game. We can control it using the same controls we did in the editor, and we can collect our boxes, and we can jump off and have us respawn. So that's it. Building with Unity is really easy. There's not a lot to it, where in UDK it's a little more complicated. You have to do some other things. Unity, it's all-inclusive, and it's from the single build settings menu. A good thing to note, and the reason I chose windowed mode, is because if you don't program something into your game, such an escape or quit menu, and you play in full screen, the only way to exit it would be to either Alt-Tab or use Control-Delete to end the process. If you do it in windowed mode here, it provides the close window, which is easy to test and check out. So that's pretty much it. This was just a short lecture on how to take whatever you've created in Unity and export it out to others so that others can play with it and or use it.